What's up guys, Ryan here, and today I'm going to show you how to do a sky replacement. I use this effect a lot in my 2017 video. If you haven't seen it yet, go check it out. I promise you'll like it. Now a lot of people use sky replacements in their videos, but most of the time it doesn't look that natural. I'm going to show you guys a few tricks that I use that'll help improve your sky replacements. Now to demonstrate, we're going to use this clip here. In order to do this, you're going to need two clips. You need your real-time shot, and then you're going to want a time-lapse. I'll show you the normal clip. Just has me walking on this ridge in Kauai. So I shot that video in 60 frames per second, and I'm going to slow it down to 40%. That's going to make it look like it's 24 frames per second. So once I've done that, I'm going to go up to File, and I'm going to click on the Adobe Dynamic Link. And what that's going to do is it's going to open up my video in After Effects. And whatever changes I make the video in After Effects will be applied to my video in Premiere Pro. Hope that makes sense. Took me a while to figure out. Once we get in there, we're going to be using the Rotoscope Tool. So I'm going to double click on the video down below on this bar here, and that's going to open up a new layer. Okay, and then once I do that, I'm going to hit the Rotoscope Tool up here on the top, and it's going to give me this green circle. And with this green circle, I'm going to color in what I want included. So it looked like it included the whole clip. Sometimes it does that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold down the Alt key and I'm going to draw out what I don't want. So I don't want this sky. So I'm going to draw the sky out. Okay. So you can see the purple line there. That looks really good. The only thing that's wrong is my hair. It has the same color as one of those clouds. So this is going to be something I'm going to need to do about frame by frame. Something about rotoscoping that is really important is that first frame, you want to make sure it's perfect because that's the frame that After Effects is going to use to base all the other frames after it. So make sure you make that first frame perfect. So I'm just going to go through. Looks like everything's going good except for my hair. So every frame, I'm just going to need to perfect that. Once I get my hairline below the horizon, it's pretty smooth sailing. Now, each case isn't going to be this easy. But since it's so contrasted between the sky and the mountains there, After Effects isn't having a problem picking that up. So I'm going to finish it. Now one thing that's really important when you're doing these rotoscopes is that you have this gray bar extended longer than the clip. Because if you don't do that, you will only be able to rotoscope as far as that gray bar is extended. So make sure it's all the way past the clip. You can also make some adjustments. If you go up here, there's the feather, contrast, shift edge, reduce chatter. We're going to use the shift edge. We're going to drop it just a little bit since the edge is going to carry a little bit of that light. But if you shift it down, it's going to take it out. It'll look a little bit more natural. Okay, so once we have all the clips in place and we're finished, you're going to hit that freeze frame down below. And what that's going to do, it's going to freeze all the frames in the rotoscope. And it's going to allow you to edit the video in Premiere Pro. If you don't do that, you're not going to be able to work with it in Premiere Pro. So we're done there. Now we're going to go back into Premiere Pro. And this is what the clip looks like. I didn't take a whole lot of time on the hair, so it's a little screwed up there. But ignore that. So now that we have the clip there, we're going to nest it. And then we're going to add the warp stabilizer. And what that's just going to do is it's going to make that clip really nice and smooth. So if it's not smooth, sometimes that sky lapse won't be super natural and you may have to track the object and attach it to the sky, and that's what I had to do in this one. It's a little bit harder. Maybe I'll do a tutorial about that too eventually. Now you're gonna need a time lapse to replace the sky with. So I have this time lapse I took in Kauai right in the same area, and we're gonna drag it beneath the clip. Okay, so we're gonna drag beneath the clip. Now you can see that the mountains are peaking up on the top. Now there's two things you could do. You could either zoom in and lower it, or in this case I'm just gonna lower it, and even though there's gonna be these black bars on top, I'm gonna be making it a widescreen video for that cinematic effect, so it won't really matter. So it just gives you some space to work with. So we got it down below the horizon. Now we're gonna go into the effects tab and we're gonna type in lumetri color. And so this is really important because it's going to let your clouds look as if it's in the environment that you're in. Like I said earlier, a lot of people screw up on this and their sky lapses do not look good. So we're gonna tweak it. I'm gonna bring down the brightness a little bit, mess with the contrast, mess with the exposure, the blacks, highlights, and we're gonna make it look as natural as possible, drop down the saturation a little bit. This is what the clip looks like, nice and finished, and then this is what it looks like with some final coloring that I applied to the clip as a whole. It looks pretty cool. Anyways, this is an effect I love to use. It kind of bends reality a little bit and adds some flavor to your videos. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to be doing more tutorials like this. Anyways, it's Ryan, and we'll see you next time.